Jan, since 1994, you have been a staff member of RAL, the Dutch organ building firm at Heerde. Previously, you worked for Ernst Leeflang, another building firm, which was taken over by RAL in 1994. I am pleased that you are willing to guide us through this magnificent organ. As the voicer of this organ, Jan, you restored it along with your colleagues. Before the restoration in 2013, the outer pipe fields were divided into two pipe fields, on top of each other. Now it is on one pipe field.
Yes, that's correct. After investigation, we concluded that these pipe fields were not divided into two floors.
Waar Jean Giudici, een Italiaanse architect, bij betrokken was. En Jean Giudici is waarschijnlijk de man geweest die op het idee kwam om veel meer pijpen in die middentoren te zetten. Maar dat zie je hier dus niet terug.
Je sprak over die. What strikes me is that the dimension of the organ pipes, especially in the outer fields, look very narrow.
Of is dat gezichtsbedrog?
Nee, dat is geen gezichtsbedrog. Die hebben ook overlengte, dus ze zien er enger uit.
That's correct. These pipes are now longer because they have a so-called overlength. And that's the reason they look thinner now.
The side cheeks on both sides of the organ look beautiful. Are they original?
Thanks to the research by the organ expert, Stef Townstra, we know that the side cheeks are original. The colors are original too.
Dus deze kleuren hebben gekregen. Ze zijn wel origineel, dus het is niet iets wat er later bij gefantaseerd is. Dat is wel heel duidelijk, dat het echt originele instrumenten zijn die dateren uit de periode dat het orgel gemaakt is.
En dan die beeldgroep, die is dan van later datum, maar daar is, heb ik het idee bij de restauratie.
The statues on top of the organ are from a later date. Nieuwe restauratietechniek. The white color is mixed with a little patina, in order to make the statues more visible from a distance.
En toen werden de beelden eerst weer keurig netjes wit gemaakt. Maar het eerste wat opviel, dat ze dus eigenlijk niet meer opvielen. In de zin dat ze het wegvielen.
Te wit.
Dus moeten ze vaak een patina hebben om voldoende de ruimte in te komen.
The organ looks as if it has always been that way.
Dat vind ik een compliment, hè?
Ja, toen we het hier aantroffen, was het dus...
Now, the great is in the place where it belongs. The positive, which was prior to 2013, above the grate, is now installed underneath the grate. In order to give the sound of this under positive effect, which was necessary for the church hall, the organ builder, advised by Stef Townstra, designed a new front under the grate. And indeed, it now looks as if this front has always been there in that way.
Shall we go inside the organ now? I hope to hear some of your secrets about the voicing of all the stops in this organ. Okay, Jan, I'll put the Voxumana in working order. Please tell me more about this splendid reed.
The Voxumana, echt specifiek voor mieren.
We copied this Voxhumana from the organ at Sommelsdijk, which is the last remaining Voxhumana made by Mera. You can see the tongue moving when it sounds.
En normaal gesproken komt de wind dus vanaf deze kant erin, vanuit de windlade, en dan gaat de toon klinken.
I'll pull the stop of the Dulcian 8 now.
De Dulciaan, niet heel vaak voorkomt.
The Dulcian 8 is rarely present in the work of Meer. We found the parts for this stop in the Jacobi Church at Utrecht. These parts gave us the measurements, like the diameter of the resonator, the length of the pipe foot, and the measurements of the shallot and the boot, and so on.
So you knew these measurements?
Yes, from Sommelsdijk and Utrecht.
Als Meren een Dulciaan maakte, dan deed hij dat op die manier dat ze zich gingen onderscheiden van de trompet.
The design and shape of this block, with this typical slant head, Does this mean anything?
This is the design as described and explained by the Dutchman Van Hoorn in his famous book, The Organ Builder, which was published at Dordrecht in 1804 and 1805.
Could you please show us some characteristic pipes?
The flute traverse, a stop that Meer loved to make. In the bass, you can hear the character of the prestant sound. In the higher regions, the so-called descant, you can hear the characteristics of a flute.
Dus ook een mensuur die naar boven toe eigenlijk steeds verhoudingsgewijs steeds wijder wordt.
This is an imitation of a treble flute. You can see that the diameter of this pipe, in relation to its length, is rather wide. And the diameter of this pipe, in relation to its length, is narrow. This tone sounds like a prestant. And this is a real flute.
En natuurlijk de carillon, die we hier ook hebben. Niet te vergeten, ook een register.
Yes, and of course the carillon. Ludwig Koning, the builder of the famous Dutch organ at the Stevens Church in Nijmegen, was an example for Meer. I don't have proof for this assumption, but I've seen the similar way they built organs, and they had a lot in common. And of course the thirds in the mixture, and the carillon.
Hij bestaat in een gedekt pijpje, een gedekte viervoet, dan een 1/3/5 en dan een 1-voet. Met die drie pijpjes samen, die zorgen ervoor dat je dat hele klok...
I'm going to improvise on this stop, to let the church rings bell.
En hier zie je dan een pijp van Onder Maris. In het register wat dit hele oeuvre van Meer niet voorkomt, maar de vertaling is golf.
And here we can see the Onder Maris.
En dat register is als eigen.
This stop was never made by Meer.
Onzuiver gestemd is. Dus het is iets lager gestemd.
The literal translation of Onder Maris is waves of the sea.
Daarom staat een heel mooi golvend effect. Ja, dat is nieuw. Dat bestaat ook uit pijpen die we.
This fits in with a fisherman in the town of Urk. The pipe is a little out of tune, a little lower as the viola di gamba 8 with which the Onder Maris is always combined with. This is the quint flute 4, and here we have the flute 4, which is stopped. And this small tube on top of this rauw flute 4 makes the sound clearer than the sound of a stopped flute 4.
Jan, would you tell us about the mechanics of the organ? And the chests, and the rollerboard.
Here you can see the rollerboard that ensures that if a key is pulled down, the tracker and the roller arm at the roller pulls the pallet into the pallet box. The groove is open and the wind can blow through the pipe. At the lowest tones, the pallets are made double in order to ensure that the lightness of the key action will be preserved.
Is it normal that there are these wooden pipes right behind the front pipes?
This is happening more often. In this case, the wooden pipes are from the hole pipe 8. The lowest octave of the hole pipe 8 is combined with the pipes of the prestant 8 in the positive. Most of these pipes are in the facade.
En dat zijn dus nieuwe pijpen die dus van 2 jaar geleden zijn.
Are there silent pipes in the facade?
Maar niet heel veel.
Not many.
Hier spreekt eigenlijk alles, bijna alles. Dus het kan, gaat het maar om een paar pijpen die loos zijn.
Aan de zijkanten.
Ja. Kijk, dan komen we zo bij het hoofdwerk. In dit geval is dat dus gesitueerd boven het onderpositief.
This door opens out on this side.
All the wind chests are new, but most of the pipes have been restored. Can you tell us about the Bourdon 16, Jan?
Part of this wooden pipe was damaged by woodworm. The part which has been repaired is lighter in colour. This can be seen. The biggest pipes are located under the chest.
De grootste die hebben we onder, zitten onder de lade.
Willem is going to improvise on the cornet.
De metalen pijpen kunnen niet zo heel veel van zien, want die zitten verstopt. De cornet opgebouwd.
Here we can see the pipes of the Prestand 8, the Bourdon 16 and the Hallpipe 8. To be able to get to all the pipes behind the cornet, we made a gangway. These are two new reed stops, Trumpet 8 and Faggot 16. This is an original Abraham Meer pipe from 1792. Before its restoration in 2013, this pipe stood in a different place. It's also been shortened. We discovered the pipe's original location and made it to its original length. An organ pipe from 1792 is very special. When we discovered this pipe, we thought, what can we do with it? Then we started to work on it, and in the end, we were amazed at the beautiful sound this historic pipe produced.
Jan, you are an organ builder and a voicer. You can make the sound of organ pipes wonderful. What's your secret?
With new pipes, I can afford myself a little more freedom. I can move the upper lip up a little in order to make more space in the flue, so I can change the character of the tone a little bit. With historic pipes, though, you're not allowed to make changes. What you can do, though, is do something with the open space of the pipe foot. A little bit warmer wind means a louder tone, and less wind means a softer and or weaker tone. You can influence the languid a little by moving it up or down. By hammering it with a little stick through the upside of the pipe or through the pipe foot on the languid in the inside of the pipe. With this procedure, you can influence the speed of producing the tone. You can also influence the character of the tone. This is the largest pipe of the Bassoon 16. This is a stop which we know that Meer never made, so we had to invent it by ourselves. Behind the Bassoon 16, you can see the other open pipes of the Open Bass 16. The lowest octave was newly made. The rest of the pipes of the Octave 8 are historic. They were made by Mart Vermolen in 1911.
When Meer built this organ, he did not build special stops for a pedal, did not he?
No, that's right. In this pedal, there is not a single stop from Meer. We had problems manoeuvring because of a lack of space. That was our solution.
Omdat er nog een randje van af moet. Want met de intonatie dan heb je de bekers aan de lange kant. En in de kerk besluit je of er nog een randje af moet. Dan is het veel makkelijker om dit stuk er even uit te halen. Dan dat je met je hele pijp moet gaan werken.
Oké, okay. The organ wind is blown away now.
These are the pallets with the pallet spring in the chest of the grate. You can also see the double pallets. That's the way a pallet is opened. The wind can reach the pipe now, through the groove, opened by the pallet in the chest. We can see the two chests of the grate, a C side and a C sharp side.
Trompet, iets van G klein of zo.
When the curve of the tongue is not quite right, then this reed sounds terrible. When the tongue is too far away from the shallot, the tone starts too slow. This is the wind supply produced by wedge bellows.
En hier staat de motor, die is op dit moment ingeschakeld. De balken zijn ook omhoog.
De motor to supply the wind.
Dit is een sensor die zit gekoppeld aan
de sensor, which has been connected to the motor.
Waar is hij voor bedoeld? Wat moet je zien?
The sensor regulates the motor by giving the motor all the information needed to produce exactly the right amount of wind. On the wedge bellows, there's also a sensor which controls the four wedge bellows, so all bellows give an equal wind supply.